I wholeheartedly and unequivocally stand behind my veto, and I'll continue to defend this lawful action of my executive authority as governor.
Texas Governor Rick Perry has responded to his felony indictment by a Texas grand jury in no uncertain terms, calling it a politically motivated, quote, farce and an abuse of power.
We don't settle political differences with indictments in this country.
The indictment in question alleges that Perry violated the Constitution by threatening to defund Travis County District Attorney Rosemary Lemberg's Public Integrity Unit if she didn't resign. Perry's allegations about the indictment mirror those made against him in the Lemberg case. In his threat to defund the Public Integrity Unit, Perry cited Lemberg's arrest and conviction for driving while intoxicated, but critics say it was a move to control one of the few state offices held by a Democrat. In the aftermath of the indictment, many outlets questioned whether it would hurt Perry's chances as a potential presidential candidate in 2016, after running for the nomination in 2012. But so far, a number of prominent conservatives have come out in support of Perry. As Politico points out, Louisiana Governor Bobby Jindal, Texas Senator Ted Cruz, and former Florida Governor Jeb Bush, three of Perry's potential rivals for the nomination in 2016, have come out in support of Perry, as well as conservative commentators.
The indictment of Texas Governor Rick Perry for abuse of his veto power and coercion of a public servant is pure, unadulterated hogwash.
And a writer for The New Yorker asked if the indictment is as potentially damaging as Chris Christie's Bridgegate scandal, saying Perry is less at fault. Christie's aides sent texts joking about stranded school buses carrying the children of Democratic voters. No one likes a drunk driver on the road. No one likes being stuck on the road either. But before talk of the political effects the indictment will have on Perry's chances in 2016, it's worth noting the nomination is still more than a year away, and Perry's odds weren't necessarily great to begin with. 538 notes Perry's polling numbers in Iowa and New Hampshire are down significantly from 2012, and Perry's repeated gaffes in 2012 would have made it difficult for the GOP establishment to support him again in 2016. Regardless of the outcome of the indictment, Perry will still have to have his mugshot and fingerprints taken at the Travis County Jail in Austin. For Newsy, I'm Sebastian Martinez.